We all know the famous call.
Coming to the finish line, Bob Jenkins, who's going to win it?
We've heard it countless times.
The checkered flag is out. Goodyear makes a move. Little Al wins by just a few tenths of a second.
Bob Jenkins helped create history that day on May 24th, 1992. Making that type of goosebump-inducing call came after years and years of working in the motorsport industry and perfecting his broadcasting craft.
Good evening, everybody. I'm Bob Jenkins.
Bob was born in 1947 and grew up in Liberty, Indiana, and attended Indiana University. As a true Hoosier, Bob fell in love with the Indianapolis Motor Speedway as a kid.
I was 12 years old. It was one of those days in which I did indeed fall in love with and have never been able to kick whatever bit me that day.
Bob's first TV appearance was for NBC, covering the inaugural kart race in March of 1979. That same year, he started with both ESPN and the Indianapolis Motor Speedway Radio Network when he called his first Indy 500.
Bob Jenkins, welcome to the Speedway Network.
Thank you, Paul. A pleasure to be on the world's greatest network. The cars have just passed by me on this parade lap, and it's a sight that you can see a dozen times. But every year, it sends chills from head to foot.
Wait a minute. Am I really supposed to be here? I'm about to be on the Indianapolis Motor Speedway Radio Network and being heard by millions and millions of people around the world. And not only that, but get to witness live the greatest spectacle in racing.
His career really took off in 1983 when the long-running weekly show Speed Week first aired on ESPN.
Hi everyone, I'm Bob Jenkins. Welcome to our premier Speed Week show.
He hosted Speed Week for 14 years and they covered everything from stock cars to off-road racing.
They would send tape or that film to us. We would watch it, we would write stories, we would edit it. And we had only four people, so I think that says something for the people that we did hire for that show.
Along with Speed Week, Bob was also part of other dirt racing projects through the years, like the very popular show Thursday Night Thunder, which later turned into Saturday Night Thunder.
You've never seen anything like this that you're going to see tonight.
He anchored NASCAR and ESPN from 1981 to 2000. He was on hundreds of NASCAR broadcasts, where he was in the booth for many iconic moments.
It's Richard Petty's final ride.
He was part of the broadcast crew for the inaugural Brickyard 400 in 1994.
Now joining us today for live coverage is the most experienced TV race caller in NASCAR, Bob Jenkins.
Hello, everyone, from the Indianapolis Motor Speedway.
Bob left ESPN and continued to work in different roles for Versus, NBCSN, and the Indianapolis Motor Speedway, all covering IndyCar and the Indianapolis 500. He retired in 2012 from NBCSN and left TV after 34 years to help take care of his wife, Pam, who ultimately lost her battle with cancer later that year.
This will be my final year doing television motorsports.
Even though he retired from TV, Bob couldn't stay away from the Speedway and the Indy 500 for long.
I'll tell you something that makes me cry unashamedly. Are the moments just before the start with the singing of Back Home Again in Indiana, the playing of taps, and all the other things that go into those pre-race ceremonies.
Bob kept his role as part of the IMS public address team from 2013 through the 2020 season.
There's nothing like a Bob Jenkins voice to make a race fan feel like they're in the right spot in the month of May.
Over the years, Bob was able to do things at IMS that he'd only dreamed of back in 1960 when he first fell in love with the Speedway. He drove A.J. Foyt's 1961 winning Roadster around the track.
You just don't know what Indy means to me, and that was the ultimate experience for me.
He was invited to wave the green flag to start Carb Day in 2012.
I didn't wave it as vigorously as I probably could, but I was all caught up in the moment.
And he was even inducted into the Indianapolis Motor Speedway Hall of Fame in 2019.
The fact I have received the ring and the medallion and been named to the Hall of Fame is my Indy 500 win. Nothing else will ever come close to this honor.
When he was diagnosed with brain cancer at the end of 2020, Bob used a few short words to eloquently encompass everything he's accomplished as a race fan, a motorsports broadcaster, and one of the legendary voices of the Indianapolis Motor Speedway.
I have only been a race fan who got lucky. And I think that's what I will have on my tombstone, because it's true.